Hi, I'm Chronic Dev, and today I'm going to make a comparison of subarray versus substring versus subsequence versus subset. These are all similar concepts, but have important differences. In an interview situation, you need to be extra careful about your choice of wording. If the question asks you to return a subsequence and you return a subset, you might fail the interview. Or the interviewer can directly ask about the differences between these concepts, as they are quite important. Let me start by describing each concept with examples. Finally, I will give you a comparison table. Subarray. A subarray is a contiguous sequence of elements within an array. For instance, the subarrays of the array 1, 2, 1 would be 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, an empty array. Things to note. You can use braces, also known as curly brackets or square brackets, to denote arrays. A subarray should be a contiguous subsequence of the parent array. As a result, 1-1 is not a valid subarray of the array 1-2-1, since 2 in the middle is skipped, so it's not a contiguous subsequence anymore. The full array itself is a subarray of itself. An empty array is a subarray of an array. You cannot have duplicates in subarrays. The element 1 appears twice in the array 1-2-1, but you can only count 1 once as the subarray of 1-2-1. Order of elements in the subarray should be the same as in the array. As a result, 2-1-1 is not a subarray of 1-2-1. Substring. A substring is exactly the same thing as a subarray, but in the context of strings. For instance, the substrings of the string ra would be ar, ra, ra, an empty string. Things to note. A substring is just a subarray that is made up of only characters. You can use single or double quotes to denote substrings. All the rules mentioned for subarrays also apply for substrings. Subsequence. Both in mathematics and computer science, a subsequence is a sequence that can be derived from another sequence by deleting some or no elements without changing the order of the remaining elements. This means a subsequence is a generalized subarray where the rules of contiguity does not apply. For instance, the subsequences of the sequence ABA would be AB, AB, BA, AA, ABA, an empty sequence. In math, it is customary to use angle brackets to denote subsequences. In programming, you can use whatever your programming language uses for arrays and lists. Unlike subarrays, subsequences do not need to be contiguous. So AA is a perfectly valid subsequence of ABA, whereas it's not a valid subarray. Subsequences still need to preserve element order, just like subarrays. So AAB and BAA are not valid subsequences. Apart from the contiguity difference mentioned above, the rest of the rules that apply to subarrays also apply to subsequences. Tip: subsequences is a great interview question topic. I have an algorithm video coming up on the longest common subsequence questions. If you want to see it when it's out, don't forget to sub. Subset. A set is a subset of another set if all the elements are contained by that set. This means neither contiguity nor ordering of elements matter. For instance, the subsets of the set 1, 2, 3 would be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, an empty set. Subsets do not need to be contiguous. 1, 3 is a perfectly valid subset. Subsets do not need to preserve element order. As a result, both 1, 2 and 2, 1 represent the same subset. While listing the subsets of the set, you can either write 1, 2 or 2, 1, and it doesn't matter. But you cannot list both at the same time, since they are exactly the same thing. Note on sets. Unlike arrays, strings and sequences, sets do not allow duplicate elements. As a result, 1, 2, 1 would not be a valid set. Tip. In this video, I've only compared the subsections of data types. However, I have a complete video on data structures with in-depth information, and I'll put the link in the description below when it is published. Comparison table. As you can see in the table, subarrays and substrings need to be made up of contiguous sequences of elements of their parents, while subsequences and subset do not have to be. In addition, all of the subarrays, substrings, and subsequences should preserve element order, meaning their elements should appear in the same order that they appear in their parents, while subsets can have their elements appear in any order. While memorizing all the details about these data structures is hard, learning them is not, and the best way to learn them is to use them in real life. Not everyone does algorithm-heavy programming, so my recommendation for most developers is to solve algorithm questions from time to time. They are not only good exercise to keep your computer science fundamentals sharp, but they will also help you to be familiar with the new and improved problem-solving techniques. Computer science is a very active branch of science, and existing algorithms are being improved every day, and new solutions for existing questions are being found. Solving an algorithm question once in a while is not only fun, but it is tremendously helpful in interview situations. If you want to keep your algorithm game up and be ready for interviews at any time, give me a sub, and in return, I will give you the best and the most popular interview questions and the best possible solutions to them. And that is it for this quick video. I will see you in the next algorithm questions video. I'm planning for a hard one that I plan to ask in the next hiring event, so watch out.